Hi, my name is Jose Luis, and welcome to this new playlist that I'm calling Fun with WebSockets, because what I would like to teach you is how to use the WebSocket protocol, which is a way of making different processes in different machines exchange data in real time between them over a network. The idea of that is that it can be used for very playful applications, the most common one being, for example, chat rooms online. But we can also use that to exchange data about geometry, animations, and synchronize form and shapes across many different devices and many different platforms. So for example, this is an example of the simple WebSocket server that we will be implementing in this series. And then these are different clients with a 2D canvas that I can click on and make this circle move towards what I clicked. What's interesting is that the information that of this click location is being sent to the server and then is being broadcasted to any of the other clients that are connected to the same server, to this one here. Every client has the possibility of being the one who sends synchronization data to all of them, and therefore we can have these four different people look at the same animation and play with the same animation in real time. And even though I'm showing this in my machine, these four browser windows could be in four different computers in four different parts of the world, because it's all being synchronized by the server that is living somewhere on the cloud. So it's really good for network for worldwide communication. I'm going to teach you how to do this, for example, with a P5JS sketch, like a simple canvas sketch on browser. I'm going to teach you how to write something in Grasshopper so that we can communicate that information as well in Grasshopper and, for example, coordinate the location of this sphere on top of a Nerves surface in the 2D space formed by this canvas. And finally, I'm also going to teach you how to write Telegram bots, which is a really fun thing. And in this, we're going to write this one Telegram bot that is also going to accept coordinates of the type, for example, can you move the ball to coordinates 0 and 0, and then the ball is going to go there? Or can you, for example, I'm going to do this from my phone, can you move the ball, because Telegram is a instant message application, can you move the ball to 1, 1, and then the ball is going to move all the way to the other corner of the, I just kidding me. So if you like what you see here, stay tuned for this playlist. I'm going to teach you how to write all of this stuff from scratch and how to connect different processes together. And if you like the playlist, you may, or if you like the work that you do in this channel, you may want to consider subscribing, hitting I like on the videos, hitting notifications, and all these things that help us send the message across in the community. All right, so let's get started with the basics of how to write first a WebSocket server, and then we'll take it from there, okay?